Good morning and welcome to our online service. We're glad you could join us today. I'll be giving an update on this week's activities. Our children's ministry session for children aged 4 to 11 will take place today at 12:30. If you have a child, grandchild, nephew, niece, friend or neighbour that would enjoy this great time of socialising with other children whilst learning about God, please email us at feedback@smallheath.co.uk or leave a comment on YouTube and one of our children's workers will be in touch. Our youth session will also take place this afternoon at 4 o'clock. If you are aged between 12 and 18 and would like to join us for a fun and interactive study session, please email us at feedback@smallheath.co.uk and one of our youth leaders will be in touch. Please feel free to join us on Wednesday evenings for our prayer and Bible study sessions. Drop a line to feedback@smallheath.co.uk and we will provide you with the joining details. In recent times, COVID-19 has impacted many in our churches, cities, communities and globally. To provide support for those affected, the Church of God of Prophecy, in partnership with other agencies, have put into place a therapy and counselling service, Sentient Support. Sentient Support is a team of qualified counsellors who are available to provide group and individual love and bereavement support for the church and wider community. To request support, call 0121 358 2231 or email sentient@cogop.org.uk. Your request will be treated confidentially and a counsellor assigned to you. If you're celebrating a birthday this week, we hope that you have a special and lovely day. If you are struggling in this period and need to speak to someone or simply require support with day-to-day errands, yourneighbour.org can put you in touch with outreach programmes in your local area who can offer assistance. The telephone number is 0300 323 9952. You can donate to our church by using internet or telephone banking. To make a one-off donation or to set up a standing order for regular giving, use the following details: Bank, NatWest, sort code 602222, account number 12388521. Please use your name and contribution type as a reference. Our sort code again is 602222 and our account number is 12388521. Words of encouragement and updates on our activities, please subscribe to our social media channels. Thanks for listening and enjoy the rest of the service.
Is our protection and our strength. He always helps in time of trouble, so we will not be afraid, even if the earth shakes or the mountains fall into the sea, even if the oceans roar and foam or the mountains shake at the raging sea. There is a river is a river that brings joy to the city of God, the holy place where the God Most High lives. Nations tremble and kingdoms shake. God shouts and the earth crumbles. The Lord all-powerful is with us. The God of Jacob is our defender. Come and see what the Lord has done, the amazing things he has done on earth. He stops wars everywhere. He breaks all bows and spears and burns up the chariots with fire. God says, be still and know that I am God. I will be praised in all the nations, and I will be praised throughout the earth. And don't we see how great, how great is our God?
God bless you, Sister Corine. Wonderful to hear the worship this morning and to hear those songs put together. How great is our God, and to break every chain, and the powerful statement, an army rising up to break every chain. I truly do believe that. God bless you. Thank you, worship team. God bless you. God bless you. This morning, our theme is, as you know, the month's theme is a new beginning. And that's taken from Isaiah 43, verse 18 and 19. But I'd like to add a little bit onto that this morning. So the theme is a new beginning. Be strong and courageous. It's a new beginning. And I really think that we need to take to heart that thought. It is a new beginning to be strong and courageous, because as Sister Corine has just sang, God is rising up his army and he's breaking every chain. Amen. Love that. Amen. And we're going to be hearing from some of our women this morning, and we're going to have some testimonies and some sharing. So the first testimony we're going to have is from Sister Pauline Arthurton-Jones. And if you could play that testimony for us. If you just listen to what she's saying and share her experiences of the last few months. Amen.
To all of God's beautiful women, men, children, I greet you in our Lord's wonderful name, Jesus Christ. All glory and praise to our Father and Son. Where do I begin? It has been, to date, a challenging year. Having retired from 40 years of service with the National Health Service in October 2019, recuperated on the beautiful island of Nevis until the end of that same year, and topping that year off with a girls' trip to Lanzarote in January, I came home to news of an aggressive form of coronavirus. How did it come about? Who knows? God knows, that's who knows. My plans of returning to work for 2 days scuppered by this virus. Why? Because I met all the criteria for vulnerability and high risk of getting this new strain, COVID-19. Having a long-term condition and being black of ethnicity and a BMI of greater than 30, now what was I to do? Trust God, that's what I was to do. There was no way I was going to just sit back and do nothing. I sourced gloves, PN filtered masks for my household, and ensured hand sanitizers, antibacterial hand wash, and effective hand care lotion. These were and are stationed in site for use. The tea towel and hand towels are neatly put away, making way for disposable paper towels. A long chat around adequate fluid intake and immune boosting diet, paying particular attention to fruit, greens, protein and oily fish, I made sure these were and are in my home. Having settled into what appeared at first to be the start of a quiet year, I was made aware of a loved one who wanted to see me for a chat. I went along, all PP'd up, only to leave sad and deflated, finding his recent investigations had indicated that he had an aggressive type of cancer. I felt I could not say no each time he phoned. I could not say no for each request of a visit, which incidentally was every day. He passed 4 months later. This was then followed by a loss of multiple friends, associates, church family, and colleagues. There are days that I'm sad. There are days I send jokes, and days I send positive affirmations of who is in control. My Father, my God, creator of all things, today I give him thanks, for I know not what tomorrow may bring. But I know what he has promised me, and if I do as he is commanded, then that a life of eternity will be mine. Let us remember all whom we have lost and smile in the hope and faith, knowing that they made it in. Why? Because it is already written. It doesn't stop us feeling sad and low at times. I don't know about you guys, but I have found having COVID-19 around, I pray more frequently, I witness more openly, and my life's narrative is different. It's actually better. It allows me to take a breath. I can breathe when others can't. Isaiah 40 verse 1. Comfort ye, my people, saith my God. Philippians 2 verse 1 and 2. If there be therefore any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, any fellowship of spirit, if any bowels of mercy, fulfill ye my joy, that ye be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord and of one mind. Beautiful brethren and people, please continue to pray for me and my house, and I will continue to pray for you and yours. In Jesus Christ, this is my testimony. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Pauline, for sharing with us your experiences. And I think what's wonderful when you hear these testimonies is people have been through such different journeys, and we only know that when we share. So I thank God for these opportunities to actually share together. Amen. God bless you, Sister Pauline, and your household. God bless you. And at this time, we're going to have a poem because, as we say, it's a new beginning. And in between our time of lockdown, different ministries and different talents and creativity has been becoming more apparent. And so we're going to move on, and I'm going to ask if we can have the dance by Zara and Victoria. And this dance is, the title of this, the music they're dancing to is Raging War. And the reason I picked this song, it's by CC Winers, is it's again in the keeping of the theme of the army of God and of us being courageous. We're in a new place, but we have to be armoured up and we have to be prepared to take the battleground. And this song just keeps ringing. It's been ringing in my heart for about 2 months, 3 months. And I just wanted to hear, to see it dance too. And I thank Victoria and Zara for saying yes to this, really, and Sister Judy for organising this. And if we could just see that dance now. Amen.
Territory, fighting unseen enemies like never before. We're waging war.
Anoint my head, oh, yeah. Anoint my feet.
Celebrating
God. Angels raining down here on the battleground.
For your glory,
for your glory. Your name, your rule, and
Sister Maureen Evelyn has also shared a testimony. I asked Sister Pauline and Sister Maureen Evelyn if they would share their testimonies of the last few months. So we're going to hear Sister Maureen's testimony now.
I'd like to greet you all in the precious name of Jesus, the soon coming King. I've given a few minutes to give all my experience through the pandemic. Where do I start? But in short, I would like to just give my experience to my memory I can recall. And quite a few of us can remember in January, beginning of a new year, all the different resolutions for those who have resolution and different aspirations and things concerning life and God. And I remember being at work and listening to the news while at work, listening, and that there was an outbreak in certain parts of the world, China and that, and thinking, oh dear, you know, this sounds really bad. But it was so far away that, you know, you couldn't, did not relate to it here. So as you do, you carry on what you're doing. And then, lo and behold, the time came where it got more serious, that it's spreading throughout the world and spreading more nearer. So you carried on, you were on your guard, and as you can be, you know, you carry on about. But I remember when it all got a bit more serious, and before that there was the fear of running out of stock and this and that, so it wasn't really taken serious until you went to the shops and you seen that the stores have been cleared, the shelves have been cleared, and this thing is getting serious. So then, meanwhile, at the same time, other things were going on in my life as well. And cut a long story short, through it all then, I was made redundant. So then now, I've spent a couple of weeks of doing searches for job, applying for jobs. And then it hit home. There is a pandemic and there's going to be a lockdown. Now, through it all, I was thinking, well, how is this? And, you know, your mind reflects back your time at church and the messages that have gone through that we can recall, redeeming the times and all different messages. And reality has struck home now. Because I remember one brother preaching and saying that we don't know if we're ever going to meet like this again. And as you do, you take it on board and that, but reality is that we never did meet again, and we haven't met again. And through it, the time of the lockdown, it has been experiences, it's time that to it's like with the sat nav, I think it's called, it re-navigates itself, your life, and the scriptures that kept you through the time of great fear, let's be honest, because we haven't been this way before, we haven't experienced it, this kind of lockdown, not in my life. And it was now the time your scriptures come to life in your life. And I remember Isaiah 40, fear not, because we're human and the human self will take on fear. And there was a lot of speculation going around, but thanks be to God, God is aware of all things. This does not surprise God at all. It surprised us. And through the time of lockdown, you hear some have been into doing gardening, baking, doing all different things. I found it on both spiritual and the temporal side a time to declutter things, still decluttering, temporal and spiritual, a time of amending things, the time of appreciating things, even just water, where you will throw away water and you will would use it wisely, how I did this, because you had no choice. You were in your house, you were in your house, to your garden, to the shop. But through it all, God has been faithful. And as from the beginning, I'm trying to bring everything together, but won't be able to do that. When they were saying that those who were going to be furlonged, well, I didn't have no way to be furlonged, because just remember, I was made redundant 2 weeks before. And I would think, oh my, where am I supposed to get finances from? But God has been faithful. He has made a way. We haven't gone hungry. We definitely ain't gone naked. And God has made a way. I remember queuing up in the supermarkets, and people were so humble. People were so friendly at the time, because we're all mining the same thing now. There's no time to be doing anything else. But it's been a humbling experience, and it's been a time of great loss and tears, not being able to support our brethren in the time of need. But thank God for prayer, that we're able to pray for our brethren through the time of this unprecedented time. And it has been challenging, but God is faithful unto the end. I remember the church services when it was given onto Zoom. I've seen the app Zoom, I've seen it, but I've never taken any notice. But it is now the time we take notice. And thank God for those that have invented the Zoom, because he's done it for his favor, and we'll be able to go on Zoom. And I remember the Sunday morning of the first of the Zoom services, I was so anxious. I'd get up ready, dress ready for church. You know, you're in your house, you can't be late. And I was so excited and so overwhelmed that we have this platform. And as it goes on, we have the Sunday services, the Luminate services that have been a blessing. And it has been an eye-opener for life and for my walk with God and things around me. I even have time, at the time, I had time to, you know, you do things and you appreciate things more, as I've repeated before. But God has been faithful, and there's been so many scriptures, you know, to keep us on our way. Psalms 91, Numbers 6, 24, Psalms 46. There's so many different scriptures that come to my mind at the time. But God has been good in a time when it has been so difficult. But have the reassurance that God is with us, and he that began a good work is faithful to complete it. Whatever speculation, whatever is being said, it sure has got the human man's attention. And for myself, it's for, we cannot go back. I cannot go back. We must move forward. God has got something in store. It's an exciting time, but a fearful time. But as the Bible said, fear not, for thou art with us. I am your God. And many will go back to what they were doing. But for us and myself, I pray God it will go forward. I appreciate God, and I thank him for keeping and his mercy through a time that is so different, so different, through many tears, too many laughters, too many, through ways that we don't even understand. But our great God, our great Jehovah, our great God will lead us and to lead me. He hasn't brought me this far to leave me, and I'm encouraged to go on. Many times things come to try me, or, you know, financially and other things, because, you know, things have changed, but God is good, and I bless his name. And the experiences I have, even with my own family, that you gather together and you appreciate that the highlight of the day was the cooking and the dinner and the discussions. But the highlights and the fun, it was my granddaughter who's been encouraged, the evangelist faith. Even her too will say, pray nanny. She would take me through all night prayer before she would go to sleep. And she will be the evangelist from the garden, jumping on her trampoline. God is good. Make room for Jesus. Make room for Jesus. And then on the other hand is government stop in your yard. Government say stop in your yard. And the neighbors would hear that. But, you know, she has been even a witness to me that when she goes to bed, she would, when I was feeling down, she would turn around and say, "You sad, Nadi?" She said, and she would turn round, and it shocked me and said, "Keep the faith, Nanny, keep the faith." And that was, I was gobsmacked. I thought she was singing song, but she said, she turned around and looked me with her eyes and said, "Keep the faith." And that is the whole thing, is brethren and ourselves to keep the faith. God is going to do something, and we ask, continue to go with us. And my thought and my scripture, well-known scripture, that I would greet my brethren when we're asked to greet one another. I don't think anybody was listening. Well, maybe there was, but my favorite scripture is Numbers 6:24, and it's, "The Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you and give you peace." And that was a scripture that I always used to say, not really knowing where it was taken from. I knew it was Numbers, but not knowing where it is. And now it is one of the scriptures with many more that are keeping us. This is my few words to know that God is still God, and he knows exactly what he's doing. Let us shine bright. In Jesus' name, I get a bit emotional, but that's it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Wonderful, wonderful to hear from another sister what God is doing during this time of lockdown. And so many thoughts there, one about fear and being courageous. And again, another testimony saying about moving closer to God during this. And something I'll hold on to, and I think we all will, little Faith, that most of us know her running about in church, but she said, "Keep the faith, Nanny." Little Faith is now encouraging her nanny. Some seed has been put in her, and now it's coming back bearing fruit. So I just thank God for that. I just think it's a wonderful thing for a child to be able to keep the faith, Nanny. God bless you. God bless you and your household. And also, God bless you, and God continue to thank you again for sharing. At this time, I believe that Joy Clayton is ready to share a poem with us. Sister Joy?
Praise the Lord. I greet Bishop, Sister Margaret, ministers, moderator, and the congregation in the name of Jesus.
Greetings.
I wrote this poem 2 months ago, and it's called Evan. I signed up to the Father of goodness and mercy. He awaits me with great anticipation and patience. He loves when you say, "I love you, sir." So what have you brought at my table, my dear daughter? My stony heart, lack of understanding, pride, arrogance, worthiness, self-centeredness. Woke up thinking something good is going to happen today. I grabbed my pen to paper, thinking, how can I pen this? God has the last say. Never put yourself down. He expects something much better from us. Age, no barrier. Sin is. Looking out into the garden, God's handiwork. Plants are there that I didn't plant. They just showed up. God's got a way of rearranging things his way. Guess what? In the garden, there is peace and tranquility, a place to read David's Psalms and to meditate. Speak to the flowers, they are God's creation. Flow into the stream of life forever. Be the pen of a ready writer. Praise God.
Amen, Sister Joy. Thank you very much, Sister Joy Clayton. Joy and joy, as we always say. I call her the little Joy. And I thank the Lord for you, Sister Joy. And I thank God for your creativity and that you know, asked to share some of your poetry with us. God bless you. And thank you for the word that God is using you to share in a different way. God is really bringing out different ministries. And we continue to pray that we will, you know, not be shy or afraid, but that we will have the courage to share what God is doing in our life during this lockdown, during this COVID, and during this time of isolation, or whatever you want to call it. Sometimes I don't even know what to call it. But Lord, I thank the Lord for the ministries and for the creativity that is coming out of it. God bless you, Sister Joy, and thank you for sharing your poem. Amen. Amen. And we're just going to have a short encouragement now before we close. And I'm going to read from Isaiah 43, which 18 and 19, which is our theme scripture for the church for this month. And that scripture is, remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. I'm just going to add on another scripture there. And that is Joshua chapter 1, verse 9. Both well-known scriptures. And this scripture says, have I not commanded thee? Be strong and of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee, whithersoever thou goest. And as these scriptures came to me and I was praying this morning, and the Lord kind of put this together in my thoughts. And it's about be strong and courageous. It is a new beginning. Israel had to have a new beginning. They had to step over from the land across the Jordan, and they had to go conquer the territories. They had to wage war. It was a different war to the one we're fighting. We're not fighting a physical war. We are in a spiritual battle. There are principalities and powers, and we have to fight on that level. We have to learn not to be carnal in terms of the weaponry that we pick up. We need to pick up spiritual weapons so that we can fight this warfare. God is telling us we're in a new place. He doesn't want us to go backwards. I heard people saying in their testimonies that they're going forwards. They're spending more time with God. They're getting closer to God. They don't want to go back to what they're doing before because they're in a new place. And that's exactly what God wanted, us in a new place, because he's doing a new thing. We've got to be in a different place to meet that. So you will see disaster. You will see pain. There's devastation. These things are going on around us. We've lost people we care about. People are sick, you know, all kinds of things are happening. People have lost their jobs. There's devastation. We're walking in a desert. But what does God say? I don't know if anybody, Sister Diane Allen sent me a video this week, and it's the second time it's been sent to me. And the title of the video, Dancing in the Desert. What a thought. You're dancing when you've got a desert around you and you've got no water or nothing, and you're in the middle there just dancing away. Why would you be dancing? Because God says, dance in the desert. When Miriam came across the Jordan, the Red Sea, sorry, what did she do? She didn't just sit there and say, oh, that was good. You know, God opened up the Red Sea. She took up her timbrel and she danced. It might seem strange, but the enemy was gone. And the time will come. We're not even going to wait for the enemy to be defeated. We're going to start dancing now. Ladies, let's get up. Get up your tambourine. Get your hands together. Let's start clapping. Let's start worshiping. Let's start dancing in the desert. God has taken us out from where we were and put us in a new place, new opportunities, new ministries are being built. In the midst of this desert, people are writing poetry. People are learning to sing and use their voice. I look at Corine doing the worship that she just done, and I see the growth, and I see the growth in her. And I know she's not the only one. God is growing people. People are saying, I'm starting up a new business. You think in the middle of the desert, you're starting a business? Yes, because God said so. All kinds of things are happening in the midst of this desert that don't make sense because God wanted us. He took us out the building. I don't know when we'll go back. And I'll be honest, brethren, as much as I love you all and I care and I miss you all, I want to hug you all up and all the rest of it. But you know what? As long as God says we're out because there's work to do out here and we need to dance in this desert. And TG Jakes was talking about dancing all over Parliament, dancing here, dancing there. I don't know where we're going next. Some of us are going into places we never dreamed of going because we've been taken out of a church building and we're doing things we never thought we'd do. Some of us were more comfortable on Zoom. We will worship on Zoom. We will lead services on Zoom that we would never have done. Some of us are more uncomfortable, but God is giving us other things to do out in our communities. I've never seen the church do so many feeding of people and doing community programs, things that we didn't do before. These new things have sprung up because we're in the desert. The world is a desert, but brethren, we've got water because God gave us water. We can share it. We can share it with others. We can share it with our community. We're not stuck in a building. We're out and we've got lots to give and we need to give it. Sister Pauline said she's witnessing now. She wasn't doing that before. Why would that be? Because we're not in a church building, because we're living in times that are unprecedented and people don't know what to do. They need us. They need us to tell them that God is real, that God is good and God's our provider. I'm not saying I'm sitting here with loads of money and everything's wonderful in my life, because trust me, brethren, I've got all kinds of pressures going on. But I tell you something, I'm going to dance. Nothing is going to stop me dancing in this desert. I am going to dance no matter what happens. I have decided I am going to pick up my tambourine, pick up my timbrel, as Sister Pat would say, and I'm going to dance because it's worth it, because I know God's going to take us out the other end of this, and we are waging war. We're going to claim those territories. So, brethren, my encouragement to you right now as we close is be strong, be courageous. It is a new beginning. Don't be afraid. When fear comes, and yes, it does, rebuke it and say, I'm going on in the name of the Lord. God's doing a new thing, but it's God that's doing it. God's got hold of this. He hasn't let go of it. He's still got hold of it. God bless you, brethren, as we close at this time. I don't know if we've been, if Sister Monica is able to unmute and pray for us, our closing prayer. Okay, it looks like we were not able to do that, but that's okay. I'm going to pray the closing prayer at this time. And God bless you, brethren, and God bless your week. Continue to be with the Lord and continue to be strengthened. I love you all. God bless you. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for being with us. Thank you for blessing us and covering us. Thank you for watching over us, oh God. Thank you for this service today, Lord Jesus. Oh Lord, you know all things. You do all things well. You encourage us, oh God, despite the circumstances that we see around us, oh God. But you say, oh God, despite these circumstances, you are asking us to sing. You're asking us to dance. You're asking us to worship, oh God. Those songs, oh God, they're not just songs anymore. Those scriptures aren't just scriptures, oh God, on a piece of paper, oh God. Their word, their life, oh God. The songs have come alive. We have to mean what we're singing. We have to believe what we're reading, oh God, that will not be lost, oh God. Strengthen us, I pray, each and every one of us, oh God. Bless our women, oh God. Bless our children. Bless our men, oh God. Bless our seniors, oh God. Just remember, you're covering me over the church, Lord Jesus. Take us forward, oh God, into new places in you, oh God. Help us not to be afraid when we feel fear coming. Help us to remember, oh God, you have control. You haven't lost control. This is your world, oh God. You made it. You spoke it into being, oh God. And you will never, ever lose control of it. Lord, we place ourselves into your hands as we move forward, oh God, taking new territories, oh God. Finding new ways, oh God, to worship and to lift you up, oh God. Finding new ways to bring souls into your kingdom, oh God. We thank you, Jesus. In the midst of it all, we give thanks in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you, brethren, and have a good week. Amen.